And yo, here it goes. Stream!
Surprise,
thank
stream.
You, Dally. But this surprise session of the yes, I have plans. But Logan should be joining us fairly shortly. But until then, recap. To recall what happened, well, basically, the gems found out that there was something going on with in a tourist trap very close to their house. So they decided to check it out and found out that there was sorry, my brain's having trouble. That it's basically okay. There was some sort of Bigfoot type thing wandering around in a tourist trap near their home. So they went to check it out, and what they found there was a gem-like creature that looked like amber. And now they are basically chasing her to try and make sure she doesn't damage anything. And last they saw of her, she was going towards the other nearby tourist trap town known as Prismwood. Is there anything? Oh yes, and they met their new sort of friend, gem by the name, their new acquaintance, a gem by the name of Azurite.
But Spec's new best friend.
Spec's other new best friend. Spec has a lot of best friends.
Spec has so many best friends, you have no idea.
Hell, even the bunnies are Spec's best friends.
Yes.
The bunnies are fine.
Spec actually never plays with the bunnies unless Tourmaline's around.
Aww. I approve.
Just because humans are already made of soft and fluffy, and bunnies are even softer and fluffier than humans, so I gotta make sure I don't break them. But, as such, you are all, unless there is something else you would rather do, somewhere else you would rather be, hanging out around the edge of the mountain, which separates the two sides. It's the mountain which is between Orchid Orchards and Prismwood. And the thing about this mountain is it's an extinct volcano that looks very similar to a post-explosion clusterfuck Mount St. Helens. Basically, it's clear that something in the past blew this mountain to hell.
I blame gems.
That's fair.
That is probably a safe assumption. And it is the place where Geode Path is, but it's also worth noting where the cave in which Azurite was living is. However, you'll have to go through you'll have to go through Geode Path one way or another, but Azurite's cave wouldn't be hard to avoid if you wanted to.
We're flying.
Well, we are going over, so.
Oh shit, right, I forgot about that. Right.
One day we'll get with that manticore.
So, you guys are actually flying over the mountain. And as you look down, you can, in fact, see just the geode path is gorgeous to look at, especially since the sun is high in the sky, so you can see the way that all the gems sticking out of the walls and ceilings, for lack of a better word, of the path, just the way they cast light all over the ground beneath them.
Tourmaline.
And there are humans snapping pictures all.
Tourmaline, who, as a point of pride, is flying slightly higher than the others, catches sight of the pretty geodes and actually remembers that she said to Ethel that she was going to try and bring back a pretty color for her. So she's going to swoop down and see if she can see any particularly nice colors.
Roll me a straight d20 for luck.
D20. Nat 1. You find a rock.
It's a very dull
A lot of
gray.
The colors are actually kind of mixing, so instead of forming a really good stained glass type color, it's falling. A lot of sort of muddy browns are being formed, but there are some really lovely little points of light, but most of those are already surrounded by humans, so up to you whether or not you want to deal with that.
She kind of hums in contemplation and then just kind of directs her colored ribbons to skate her upwards again, making a mental note to come back later.
Okay. So, I would like everybody to roll either Perception or Arcana.
Perception,
also, hello, is there a Logan?
Hello, Logan?
Damn it, Dally.
Sorry.
Oh, Arcana, you say?
Oh, Perception, you say? Meh. I mean, oh.
I'm not going to stop that.
What was the damn it, Dally?
Alright, you can hear us now?
I am so sorry. Anyways.
Logan?
Yeah,
it's all right. So to get you caught up, basically everyone is flying over geode path towards Prismwood and snapping some pictures. Oh, and by the way, some of the humans are snapping pictures of you.
Why does the color of camera flashing and sounds like that always have to be such an ugly color, Rihanna?
Oh, Eli, can I corrupt those files?
Right. Roll science, or sorry, roll Arcana.
They're blurry, or they've got their thumb over the lens.
Okay, so as such, sorry.
I just wanted to say Moonstone makes a note to see how much photographs of them will sell on eBay or something. Hey, at least he'll get money now.
Tourmaline just waves awkwardly.
Fair point. So, hang on, let me look through the rolls. Alright. Everybody but Trinitite notices that there's something a little... As you're flying over, you can see the place where one of the tourist traps you guys avoid is... And that is the Nexus, which, for those who don't have access to the dock, one of the tourist traps on the Prismwood side is a series of broken ancient stone platforms arranged in a circle, similar to Stonehenge. There are many theories about what they mean, but the gems know what the truth is, and they avoid the place like the plague.
Fuck, don't need any homeworld gems coming back to kill me.
But you can see, everyone except Trinitite can see, that there's a bit of odd visual activity down there. Well, except Trinitite and Moonstone, because Moonstone didn't roll so hot. But, Tourmaline can see that... There seems to be a tiny little red insect-looking thing crawling around on one of the platforms and spraying it with a sort of a foamy red liquid.
Tourmaline's eyes go wide, and she immediately drops out of the sky onto the platform that Pyrite made and grabs Pyrite by the shoulders. Pyrite, there's something at the Nexus. It's doing something to the teleportation pads.
Pyrite looks at it and attempts to determine what the fuck is going on.
Not sure what you'd roll for that.
Probably I kinda...
You could roll perception to try and get a better look, or you could roll stealth to try and get closer without whatever it is noticing you. Oh, and you notice that there aren't a lot of humans by the Nexus right now. It tends to be one of the less popular attractions, and the bug is deliberately seeming to stay out of their way.
I could roll stealth.
Alright. Note, in rolling stealth, you are getting closer.
Yep.
And
possibly getting off the
moving
platform. What?
Yeah, she is.
With Eagle Eye, I can see small objects and find details up to a mile away.
Yes. Thank you for mentioning that, because you can see that this thing, it is kind of this sort of four-legged... Not quite an orb or a sphere, just sort of oblongoid. And it is just crawling and spurting red foam over the cracked and splintered platform.
Is it trying?
As it does, the...
Yeah, Eli, you're stalking.
Yep.
And...
sort of a... sick...
Zark! Yep, Azor sort of puts a hand over his eyes, trying to get a better look, points at the thing, and goes, I think it's trying to fix the Nexus, or at least fix the cracks.
She just,
have to break them again.
So what you see is that there is, it's very much an insect-looking thing, even though it's about the size of a football. And as it's crawling around, it keeps just sort of leaking and spitting out this red foamy fluid, which as it covers the broken and cracked pedestal is causing the cracks to recede and to fill in.
Shit, it is fixing it.
Good. I'm gonna have to go break those again.
She just kind of shakes Pyrite by the shoulder. We can't let them.
You're right, we can't. Pyrite will... yeah, basically trying to destroy the thing. Pick it up and then bash it into a wall.
Okay, you guys haven't quite reached the thing yet.
With telekinesis.
Oh, okay. How far is your range on that?
I think it's 45 feet. 75 feet.
You are not nearly close enough to do it yet.
Yeah, it's 75 feet.
It will take you about 5 minutes before you're within spitting distance of it.
5 minutes? Damn.
It's a big platform. It's not the fastest thing on the planet.
Yeah.
Tourmaline is fidgeting, and you can tell that it's taking a lot of self-control for her not to fly off ahead.
And
we need to stop this. I can't reach it.
Spectrolite says, but hold it. If it's fixing the teleporter, then couldn't we meet some others? Like, new people?
We don't know if they'd be friendly, Spec.
Yeah.
I don't...
Moonstone kind of... sorry.
What if they make us go back to Homeworld? I don't want to go back. I like you here.
And Moonstone. What's Moonstone saying?
Moonstone kind of nods at what Tourmaline is saying. Yeah, we've been away from there for so long. It's not... kind of like it here as well. And they might want to do... he kind of glances at the group. And just goes quiet again.
But... okay.
Spec, I promise you we'll explain it properly later, but right now, we need to stop that bug doing what it's doing.
Okay, and Spec will actually jump off the thing and start using his own flight to try and get there.
Tourmaline is going to spiral up into the air with her ribbons again, and then just start skating along to keep pace with Spec.
The Trinitite does try to hold out his hand to stop someone, but doesn't...
not to stop someone, to someone that wants to stop it.
When you do that, Spec says, I can't really hold your hand while I fly.
Tourmaline looks vaguely confused and flies back so that she's hovering by Trinitite. Trin, what is it?
He holds out his hand to her, and then points to the ground.
Okay, hold on. And she will sort of carry him up in the air by two hands and lower him to the ground.
When still holding on to her, he's going to do lightning speed to the thing.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
I think I can flash teleport there.
For the next 2 seconds, I may move up to 30 miles per second.
Okay, so, you definitely get there before Spec does, because Spec's not very good at flying.
Well, considering it's less than a mile away, I'm there in a split second.
How far is it?
Eli, can I use Fabricate to make the platform faster?
You'd be using your other use a day.
Well, no, that's for... I use Crazy Construction to make the platform...
You get that once a day.
Yeah, but Fabricate is a separate ability. It's a two-day ability.
Oh, right. No. Okay. You could roll Arcana to try and make it move faster, but...
I would like to do that.
Okay. You roll that, and yes, like Logan said, reminder, plus one from Grandeur.
Mm-hmm.
But, Trinitite and Tourmaline are already there, and you guys can see the little red football-looking pill bug type thing. God damn it, I hate living by a freeway. Still kind of spewing its fixie goo all over it.
Trinitite just kind of staggers a little.
You mean Tourmaline?
What did I say? Sorry.
Yeah.
So many names. Tourmaline. Drops out of the air and staggers a little on her feet. Trinitite, I wouldn't mind a little warning next time you do that. But she's kind of very much more distracted when she sees the bug. And looks around uncertainly. Shall we wait for the others before we engage? Though you notice her gem is glowing and she has just summoned her bow staff.
Trin's going to look at the platform that is at least 5 minutes away from them.
Mm-hmm. It's a little less than 5 minutes, and Spectrolite will probably be here within a minute, though he won't make the most graceful landing on the planet.
Question, how fast does the goo fix the platform?
Pretty fast.
Yes. It basically, it's like putting a video of a spiderweb crack going through glass in reverse.
Oh, that's fast.
So presumably the things that he's already, that the bug has already sprayed are now fixed. Eli?
Probably.
What?
The entire thing will probably be fixed in less than a minute.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's okay. I can flash teleport down there. Is it? We're within 30 feet, aren't we?
No. Don't think you are.
No.
Sorry, what happened?
Smarty was asking if we were in 30 feet, and I was asking if the teleport pads that had already been sprayed had now been fixed.
You are not, and only one teleport pad is currently being sprayed.
I'm going to telekinesis it.
Telekinesis what?
The bug.
All right, you lift it up. It keeps spurting red fluid all over it, the teleport pad, faster, in fact.
I will telekinesis that before it hits the pad. And then just push it off to the side, so I don't have to hold up that. So I can combine weight of 50 pounds or less.
All right. By the way, is anyone else here in Catter Robot a little?
Yeah.
It might be because I'm hosting the call.
I can hear it.
I didn't know you were hosting. Do we want to restart with Smarty or anything like that?
Yes, maybe.
Okay.
Please hold.
Hello?
We back?
Hello. We back.
Thank you.
There we go.
Pardon me, retcon that whole thing, because I forgot that telekinesis only works on sand.
You could only telekinesis sand.
In which case, can I do a thing?
Mm-hmm.
Tourmaline quickly kneels down next to Trin and whispers, Trin, I know you don't like fighting, so I'm going to distract the bug. You try and undo whatever it's doing to those teleport pads, okay?
He gives a very short nod.
We'll do whatever we can to stop this until the others get here to help. And then she just takes a running leap at the bug and attempts to thwack it with her bow staff.
You thwack the bug with your bow staff and it explodes and it gets just foam everywhere.
You are now covered in fun.
You and the teleport pad.
It's on me. She looks around, panicking.
Give me some. Ooh, hang on. Let me check my.
Everything's gone purple again.
Purple is Tourmaline's normal state of being, though.
Tourmaline is slightly a redder shade of purple.
Oh my god.
Though I suspect it's a very beautiful shade of red. So, Trine is probably going to keep a small piece of it for the color for Tourmaline.
Sorry, I'm back. Okay, so, did what came through?
Exploded into goo.
And it exploded into goo. Both Tourmaline and the teleport pad. And I think you were going to have me roll something.
Endurance.
A barrel.
Endurance? Oh, crap. I don't think that's a good skill for me.
That's my second best stat.
Yes, well, you
for
are.
For the
right.
record, the slime is sort of light red.
Oh, fuck. Tourmaline's not doing well, you guys.
Would it be possible that Trine can somehow jump
you
away from
have
that? A... Like, and take the endurance roll himself?
Not really, considering she's the one who whacked it.
Thank you, all the same, Hatter.
Well, because he has a massive bonus to endurance and athletics.
Okay, but the thing is, you feel good. Like, you feel really healthy. Huh. Like, almost fresh out of the earth healthy.
That's weird. She just kind of looks at herself. Is she still red, or is the foam fading?
The foam is fading, just sort of turning to steam, and as it sort of dissipates off you, or sublimates, you can see that it's almost like you've been freshly buffed.
Huh.
Been polished.
Your skin is shiny, and any scratches you might have had are completely gone. However, the pad lights up beneath you, and
While that was happening, I was going to do something to the pad.
Okay, go on.
Can I roll athletics or endurance to try and smash the pad?
Athletics. But for the record, as this is happening, Spectrolite crashes, and the machine is about halfway there, 2 minutes away now.
How far can someone fall in 2 minutes?
I can, as long as it's within 30 feet, I can be there in seconds.
It's not enough.
I can fall to 30 feet, then teleport.
How many flash teleports do you get per day? Is it a one a day thing?
Two.
Yeah.
I only used five minutes.
37.
Oh, dear. I forgot you had fun athletics things.
Athletics and acrobatics. Athletics and endurance. They aren't technically that good at numbers, but I have physical powers.
Okay, so you slam into the thing. And it lights up, but then halfway through, it just sort of spits out and starts spurting light instead of a large stream as it was.
Is she still on the pad?
Yes, she is. However, the slime hasn't completely sublimated, and it starts hissing back towards the place where you've cracked it.
Can he leap towards her and try and knock her off the pad?
You can.
What would I roll for that? Acrobatics?
Yes.
Yay! The same again.
Can I do something silly and sweet at the same time? Tourmaline's gonna do the exact same thing to Trin.
It's going to collide in the air
yes. Would that be athletics or acrobatics?
Acrobatics, please.
Excellent, that's slightly higher. I'm still going to lose, but
I got a 28. I don't know how good that is, but
you beat me.
Well, yeah, but still, I'm not sure if 28 is good enough.
You both kind of hit each other, and Trinitite does manage to push Tourmaline just barely off of the Nexus.
She stumbles in the meantime, and stabilizes herself with her bow staff.
Spectrolite crashes on the ground nearby, and the big ship is within about a minute.
Spec.
And now, I'm fine. What's the thing doing? And for the record, the thing is, the red slime has gone back into the place where Trinitite damaged it, and it started glowing again. And yet you guys can see two shapes forming inside of it. And you reckon you have about 5 seconds before whatever is going to forms. For the record, everyone in the air can see this as well.
No, 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 no. And she starts frantically bashing at the teleport pad with her bow staff.
I will do the same.
Both of you roll athletics.
Oh, goody, because that's not going to be good for me at all. 31.
23.
I am totally fine if you fudge it so that they don't do it, because I'm curious to see who these guys are. But this is.
Oh,
just...
yeah, no, totally. I'm okay, but that's
but
what he, well,
they had to try.
Told them, yeah, if she's doing that, so is he.
Yes. You guys are still trying to hit it, but... you still haven't actually removed the red stuff, so it just keeps going and fixing the stuff that you break. So, after 5 seconds, Spectrolite actually grabs you both and tries to pull you away to hide behind one of the other rocks.
Tourmaline,
will you let him do that?
Yes. Hatter?
Oh, yes. Yeah. Yes.
And then... the thing finally finishes, and you can see, give me a minute to find the description here. Here we are. You can see a pearl, actually, with a dark bronze skin and shoulder-length orange hair, but... by Pearl's standards, she's actually very tall and quite muscular. That doesn't mean a whole lot, since she's still a Pearl, but she's kind of tough looking. And, as such, along with her appears someone who's sort of the exact opposite. She is this, sort of... light teal color with darker teal splotches all over her skin, and with a very short and squat pear-shaped body. And she has half a head of light blue hair, but the other half is shaved, or at least you assume it is, because she's wearing some sort of bizarre helmet with sort of a... Gem Cutter's opera glasses type thing. And she has just the widest grin on her face. Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. We're here, Beege, we're here! And the Pearl is trying to stifle a grin of her own. And she says, Mill, remember, we need to stay focused, just supposed to be an in and out, in and out. We don't know what's on this planet, especially since something kept trying to... Yeah, I know, kept trying to break the thing. Send a report back to the big guy on that, by the way. Make sure your boss knows about that, but... holy shit, look at this planet! And she starts clambering up one of the taller rock spires. And the Pearl's just like, Milk, careful! We need to... And she climbs up after her.
Meanwhile...
they don't seem to have noticed rock. You. Any of you. Not even the giant flying albatross mechanism.
Ignore us.
Is starting to fall apart, by the way, since crazy contraptions don't last forever.
At this point, then, Azurite's throwing himself down. In a way that he gets closer.
Pyrite's putting it towards the ground. I thought
you'll be able
be
to
faster.
Land it before it. Fades away.
Okay.
Is Azurite still throwing himself and falling and falling?
Okay. They're kind of looking the other way from you because the shorter one says, oh my gosh, they're sentient life. Oh shit, I haven't seen fauna like this in so long. Can we look at them? Can we? And the pearl's just like, no, Milpreve, we cannot. We cannot look at them. We're just supposed to check on the glasswood, all right? Well, if that's the case, then why didn't we materialize eyes closer? Because all the other things are broken.
You're welcome.
Onyx is like, wasn't me.
It was totally me.
And, fine. The shorter gem climbs down, clearly just looking very put out. And she looks around, and her eyes peg on the stone behind which the three of you are hiding. And at this point, all the other uncut gems, if they were running or using something else to get closer, are within spitting distance.
Yeah, Moonstone definitely was.
So, what does anybody want to do?
Let me know when I get to floor.
I already said what I'm doing.
You did? Oh, yes. You typed it, but,
Yes.
You land within, like, 30 feet of it, and when you do, Milpreve turns to look at you, and she says, "Holy shit!" And she hides behind the pearl, who she has her pearl on the back of her hand, and with just a quick swish of her wrist, she forms three sort of wolverine-like claws.
Well, isn't this polite?
Are we getting our weapons out already? All right. Sledgehammer leans on it.
But, So, still wondering what you guys are going to do besides those who've mentioned what they're going to do.
I do want to specify that if nothing has occurred within that minute, he's just going to, like, hold the process. Like, he's just going to hold it and wait. So if they try running, or if they try fighting, he can cast it.
Alright.
Tourmaline has been exchanging wide-eyed glances with the other two, but from their hiding place, and is just kind of silently freaking out. She has her weapon ready, and I'm basically holding an action for her to leap out if need be.
Alright.
So she's getting ready to appear, but she is holding that.
Onyx just got down with Azurite and he's just standing next to them.
Yeah, Azurite's gonna stand up, lean on his cane and go, "So, how can we help you?"
Since everybody's taking their weapons out, Moonstone pulls the things out of their cheeks and attaches them together, spinning them carefully. Just basically looking very protective.
She's just leaning on the sledgehammer.
Milpreve is hiding behind the pearl, who says, and she actually says, "Beach, do you think this would be, one of those we're allowed to use the emergency channel type things?" And the pearl says, "Not yet, Mill." "We are representatives of the home world."
"Oh, for fuck's sake."
"Yeah, we got that. Can you just skip to the important part, like why you're here?"
"That's classified and almost certainly above your pay grade."
"I don't get paid."
"Then also, it's definitely above your pay grade."
"Also, why are you talking?"
Beej, just the girl just stares at you and says, want to run that by me again? And she, the claws get longer. But Milpri's just like, no. Come on, Beach, let's do something else now.
No, I'm fine with this.
How many years have you been out of the Earth? How many years have you been alive, little girl?
Which one were you directing that at?
It was an open question.
Well, years... by years...
What kind of years do you mean? Says Milpreve, and the Pearl says, Mil, don't answer their questions. We do not need to respond to these. Come on.
What is it here? Like, what, 365? 66?
365.25 days in a year.
That,
then. And she uses her offhand to take Milpreve's hand, and she says, look, we're not warriors. We have no quarrel with you. Stay out of our way, and we'll stay out of yours.
Yeah, that's the thing. This is kind of all of our way, so...
Tourmaline's peeking from behind the telepads, if you can see them.
Milpreve tries to wave at you, but Pearl just sort of tugs on her arm.
I don't know how it seems to everybody else, but you two are pretty much trespassing on our home.
This is Gem territory, you morons!
Yeah, well, but this is our planet. Well,
Gem territory, kinda. That was, you know, when the homeworld was beaten nearly 5.5 millennia ago.
Moonstone also raised a hand. Also, we're gems. Our territory.
Hi.
kind of thought that was kind of obvious.
No, we're just crazy people with weird colors.
Let me rephrase that.
I have a question.
Yeah?
Oh, never mind. You answered.
Damn, no sand! No
sand, yeah.
I had an awesome idea.
So I can crush a rock.
You're the one who chose sand as your controllable thing.
Okay, so and we're going to need to start bringing a bag of sand around with us.
Carry a giant gourd on your back.
I was about to say.
I got a jar of dirt. I got a jar of dirt.
Yes, what's inside it? Yes.
It's a hand.
But the Pearl just face palms with the hand with the claws on it and says, I don't care if this is a contested zone. The homeworld gems own this planet.
Yeah, sure.
At this point, Tourmaline stands up and nervously readies her bow staff. Actually, there's already a dominant knife form on this planet, so you guys can't really have it.
The planet's kind of taken.
There are humans.
Whether or not we have it has nothing to do with...
No, but see, there are humans here. So, the homeworld really shouldn't interfere. There's like 6 billion of them. Like, more like 7 billion of them.
She uses her claws to rub at her forehead, but as she does, Milpreve pokes her head out from behind her and says, there won't be humans for long.
No,
yeah,
but,
see, that's,
no,
that's
the
way
thing.
You're wrong.
I like the humans. You can't just... Not again.
I fought for them to survive here once, I'll fight for it again.
Did humans exist at that time?
you don't get it. I mean that in this place, there won't be humans for long.
Yeah, that's still kind
what
of...
What do you mean this place? Do you mean the planet? Do you mean... What?
This specific area?
I mean, individual humans don't live long, but... And they move around. They'll be on the planet for like... Well, if they don't destroy themselves for hundreds of thousands of years.
Well, we're coming to check up on the Glasswoods and the Pearl covers Milpreve's mouth.
No, please continue. I'm intrigued.
And Spectrolite pokes his head out at this point and says, yeah, I want to hear more. Also, tell me about the homeworld. What's the homeworld like?
Know where you want to go.
Yeah.
Moonstone also speaks up for a moment and says, sorry.
It's not someone you want, somewhere you want to go, Speck. It's a very terrible place.
Moonstone kind of...
Go on.
Moonstone kind of speaks up for a moment and says, oh, yeah, feel free to continue telling us. It might convince us not to do anything. And I'm rolling persuasion.
Please, relay to us your entire evil plan. I mean, if we're rolling persuasion, I'll do it as well, because fucking persuasion's my best skill.
Alright.
Before you do anything, would the Pearl be rolling something themselves to counter the persuasions? I mean, like, I don't know if they're...
I just put up a DM determined thing.
I was just asking for virtue of I think, what's the official name of it? Dirty Look. Target creature self with a minus 10 penalty, but if it's not a check, oh well.
Alright, what are you saying, Onyx?
Just like, no, please, continue. I want to hear this plan.
Alright. You hear Milpreve keep talking, but she's being stifled by the Pearl's hand. Yeah. Look, this is clearly more than we bargained for. So, if you guys want to let your little humans get destroyed by a failed science experiment, that's your business. We'll just go home and tell my boss that this was a wash, so he'll know that it might be more lucrative for us to just nuke this from space.
Wait, what do you mean failed science experiment? Is this about the gold? Is this about the glass woods?
Also, you've heard of it.
No?
Yeah, we kind of...
Moonstone kind of pulled the page from Onyx's book and says, yes, about, 10 seconds ago, by virtue of one of you two?
Yeah.
Tourmaline is kind of hunkered down on the ground and hugging Trin at this point, though she still has her bow staff out.
And Spectrolite says, is this about Amber? And, Milpreve actually bites it's down on the Pearl's hand, and she pulls it away instinctively, and she says, yeah, do you know about her? And Spec says, I do! She's all tall and spindly and has, like, these wings and all these little things inside of her. And Milpreve tugs on the Pearl's arm and says, They know. That's, shit, I don't know if that's good or bad.
Wait. Did you make Amber? Did you make her... She's part bug.
Part what? Says the Pearl.
Bug.
There's a dragonfly inside her gem, so she's part gem and part bug.
It's actually quite creepy.
She has wings like a dragonfly. What did you do?
Moonstone tilts her head. Wait, do you even know what insects are? I don't remember if we have any on Homeworld.
Milpreve's eye goes wide and she says, insect, local flora, small, low evolution.
You mean fauna? Chain.
Sorry, fauna.
Okay, just making sure.
That was my mistake, not Milpreve's.
Oh, good to know.
And the Pearl smacks her in the back of the head, and she stops.
Oh good, so at least one of you knows what an insect is.
Why do you keep abusing her?
And one of you is an insect.
It,
Wait, actually, when you say that, the pearl just gives you such a steely-eyed glare.
I flip her off.
It is the sort of glare that could melt it's the sort of glare that could boil ice.
Onyx is unfazed and flips her off.
She's not sure what that means, not being from Earth.
Yes. But
I believe the general gist of its meaning would transfer at least partially.
The general gist of the idea. Oh, fuck off.
Moonstone turns to Onyx and does, no, you should remember how to do it for homeworld gems. And does the equivalent, which I will think up later.
The gem equivalent of flipping the bird.
Frack off.
Pretty much.
But no. Pearl, why do you keep Bill abusing Priebe her? Bill
is visibly confused, and she says, wait, if she's half organic material, then I'm not abusing her. It's my job to make sure that she doesn't cause things like this to happen, which, actually, I'm failing. So, Milpreve, we're leaving.
But we haven't done our job yet, and I've barely gotten any...
This is a dangerous situation. I'm supposed to keep you safe, so I'm doing my job.
Well, hey,
Moonstone uses quick speed to get it between them and the teleporter pad.
How many uses of that do you have per day?
Two.
I have two. So I have one left.
You used one yesterday?
No. Yeah, I used one last one, so I have two. I used one, so I have one left, so I'm using it.
Okay.
So Moonstone goes between them and puts their hands on their hips, still holding a weapon. Not yet. We still have some stuff that we want to talk about.
Look, we're fine with just, you know, letting you leave and maybe, you know, pretend you forgot about us and don't have to come back and don't have to destroy us. Just kind of leave the Earth alone, but maybe first you could tell us what we should do about Amber. We don't want anything getting hurt here. I don't really want her getting hurt either if she's just, you know... This doesn't sound like her...
Zog.
Oh.
Zog. He was on the roll there.
Okay, I think I might be coming back. Sorry, what did I miss?
What was the last thing you heard?
Last thing I heard was Moonstone putting their hands on their hips.
And then they said, not just yet. And then Dali went into adorable Tourmaline nervous babbling.
So Tourmaline says... we'd be happy enough to let you go. I mean, like, maybe if you forgot that you saw all this here and maybe just decided not to bother with Earth anymore and didn't blow it up and didn't come back, but maybe first you could tell us what to do about Amber, because we don't exactly know how to handle her, and, you know, if she was made, then it's not really her fault that she is this way, and I don't want her getting hurt or anyone else getting hurt, so maybe you could help us with that. I mean, you started it.
And nope. Milpreve says,
well, I can't forget that all this happened. It's all up here.
And she flicks her helmet. And the pearl puts her offhand on Milpreve's shoulder and just clenches her fist around her claws and glares at Moonstone.
Eli, can I hack into the...
I don't want to hurt you. Please get out of the way.
Can I hack into the helmet?
You'd have to roll Arcana. Yes. Roll Arcana.
Whilst that's happening, I'd like to do some audiomancy.
And you're in the right rolls room, right? Because your last few rolls I never saw.
Okay.
Yeah.
F-E-S-2. I'm sure that's a smart name.
Is F-E-2-S-U or F-E-S-2?
Oh! Oh, that is really smart of you!
I'm sure it is, but I don't get it.
It's Pyrite's chemical compound.
Oh.
Yeah.
Nerd jokes.
But yes.
Oh.
That was my role. It was shit.
So yeah, at the Pearl's comment, Moonstone
yes,
just...
it was.
Yeah, at the, and at the Pearl's...
this is very, very new and expensive gem technology. You're not able to hack into it.
Can I do some audiomancy, please?
First, what was Moonstone saying?
Moonstone just kind of pulls their weapon back up, idly spinning the weapon portion. I would love to let you guys by, especially because some of my friends don't really want to fight you guys. But you did just threaten the entire planet and therefore us. I'm a little bit nervous about letting you guys go myself.
I myself could certainly make you stay.
That wasn't a threat. It was a statement of fact.
Yeah,
so we were just trying to get in, get our job done, and leave. But anyway, what were you wanting to do with your audiomancy?
I want to cause a sound that's pretty much just a whisper inside. I can't remember her name. Her helmet.
Milprieve?
Yep.
Alright, what do you want it to sound like?
I want it to be... I want it to be Azor's voice going, if you just step away, I'm more than happy to show you this world. You just need to step away and trust us. She's not going to help you here. All she's going to do is hurt you.
Roll persuasion. And you know what you can do? Actually, I have a say. Where is it? Oh, let's see what you get first.
Is it possible to hero point that?
Actually, no. I can instead, and I can do that better because I have. Where is it? I was looking right at the stair. Oh, which is just Onyx Glare.
All right.
Which is me.
Go ahead and do that.
Me or someone.
Remind me what it does.
Me or someone I can see makes a persuasion check. After seeing the result of the roll, you can add 20.
All right.
So, yeah.
So.
40.
Milprieve turns and looks at you, smiling widely, and says, you'd show me this world? And the Pearl grabs her by the hand and jumps up and tries to stab Moonstone. So I'll want you to roll endurance.
Moonstone decides to put their hands up and say, don't touch me. Compassion. Also known as...
Three of us have compassion?
Compassion, Scott!
it's cheap as frick. But basically, the moment she shows hostility, Moonstone's cheeks glow, and they go like, you're not going to touch me. And non-hostile for 5 minutes. And
the
I also...
Pearl stops with her claws like an inch from your face, and she is visibly confused.
I get a sense as to why she was hostile towards me, but I'm guessing I was just in the way.
The sense of why she was hostile was it's her job to protect Milprieve, and you are dangerous. You are in the way of her job.
And at that sense, Moonstone plops their weapon back into their cheeks and holds up their hands. I don't want to hurt her. None of us do, like I said.
Bullshit!
If we wanted to hurt her, why haven't any of us already started to attack you?
It's pretty much true. If anybody would have wanted to hurt anybody, it would have been me, and I'm still here, so...
Milprieve, has anyone told you you've got a beautiful blue voice?
Are you trying to get on the enemy?
Oh, you trauma, you.
I see sounds as colors.
Mm-hmm.
Milpreet is very visibly confused by this.
So yeah, at the Pearl's comment, Moonstone just even goes so far as to slide their free hands out of their shirt to raise them again, staring at the Pearl. You see my friends, don't you? And one of them's passed out over there, basically out of.
Don't know what I see right now.
In the corner, slightly.
This was supposed to be an in and out.
Behind the teleport pad, Trinitite is shaking really badly, and Tourmaline is starting to freak out and just kind of holding him and going.
And I'm just trying to make sure that we get the information we need, and Milpreet doesn't get
Eli?
We can.
Eli?
I think Eli's jogging.
Oh, shh.
We can hear you, Dally.
Oh, goddammit.
Eli, I think he's just lagging.
Yeah.
How much?
Yeah, no. Everything that Tryon was like wanting to help with has gone out the window at this point. Just
yeah.
Eli, can you hear us?
I can show you. The...
Okay, I'm back. Sorry. Okay. How much did I zark for?
A lot.
Well, it's more that you were talking. But you couldn't hear us because you kept talking over me.
Sorry.
You obviously couldn't hear me. It's fine.
Okay, what were you trying to say?
I was just trying to mention that behind the teleport pad, while Trin is freaking out, or rather, well, Trin is just looking really not okay and shaking quite a lot, and Tourmaline is starting to freak out a little. And is just kind of holding him by the shoulders and kind of going, Trin, it's okay. It's okay, right? What's wrong, Trin?
Alright.
He doesn't even acknowledge your existence at the moment.
Ew, boy, that's sad.
Well, you have to understand with his backstory, they said like two magic words that you do not say around him.
Nuke.
Oh, boy.
Nuke and genocide, basically.
She's just she's kind of going really wide-eyed because we don't actually know this backstory, so she doesn't know why he's freaked out. But she can tell he's not doing okay, and she's just at this point she's just flung her bow staff away and is just hugging him tight. It's okay, Trin. We're not going to let them hurt anyone.
As you guys. The Pearl is very visibly just still confused and rather frightened. But, meanwhile, Milpreve sort of dislodges herself from the Pearl and goes over to Spectrolite, actually. And she basically just pulls his arms apart and starts looking at his gem. The heck are you? And Spectrolite's just...
It's Javolt. Touch the thing to know the thing.
He's getting such hate daggers from Onyx.
Don't you hurt him, only I could hurt him.
And you can see the little, the sort of eyepiece on her helmet just zoom in and out.
Igneous. Lots of extraterrestrial materials. Don't look over 6,000 years old.
Spec says, "That's how old I am."
That's less than. Well, that's less than my age.
Oh my god, she'd have a field day with Trin.
And then she goes over and starts doing the same to Pyrite. Basically, just grabbing her by the hair and pulling her down so she can take a look at her gem.
Stop that, stop!
Pyrite will punch her in the face. Because Pyrite...
Ow.
You may treat other metals like this. You don't treat me like that.
When you punch her, that is an act hostile enough to end kindness on the Pearl.
Good job.
and now she charges at you.
Okay. Pyrite will use force field on... Okay. Pyrite will try to run towards her friends, the nearest ones, and then use force field.
Force field takes a minute.
She's going to hit you way before it. You put up a force field.
And then you're going to be in the force field with her.
We take 1 minute of perforation time.
Pyrite kicks up some dust and freezes it.
You can only do that with one thing.
Rock.
Dust.
Alright. And... when you do that, she just has to ducks underneath it and takes a swipe at your legs.
Okay.
So you guys can roll initiative, or you can try to stop this without combat.
Pyrite takes it.
Really, Pyrite, did you? You couldn't hold yourself back for 5 fucking seconds.
I'm going to try and stop it without combat.
I have a...
Try and do it, Jack.
Pyrite gets 1 damage.
Okay.
I have a thing I kind of want to do, but I can wait until Azure moves first.
What would you like to do?
Pyrite stands still.
Tourmaline was going to basically try and latch onto Pearl's back. As a kind of futile attempt to get her to stop hurting her friends.
So, how long does unstoppable force last? Immovable.
How long does it say?
It doesn't say.
What does it do?
Oh, 10 minutes. Pyrite will stop herself. It takes 6 seconds, so she has 6 seconds of being beaten.
It has to be a small object.
Fuck. Okay, Pirate will just stand there.
Unless someone tries to... when Tourmaline jumps on her back, she just...
Please don't hurt her. She didn't mean it. She's just... Your friend started manhandling her, and that's not okay. She can't do that. Please, she didn't mean to hurt. She's not going to hurt. We're not going to hurt anyone.
Then let us leave, or let us do our job.
But if you leave, you're going to blow us up.
We're not going to blow you up.
No, but we're still going to get blown up, and that's the thing.
What's
going
to happen when you go and you tell them that there's gems here and that the experiment is a wash or whatever, then what's going to happen?
Actually, could I show... I'd like to show you two something, if you don't mind. Both you, Miss Pearl, and your friend.
Milgrave looks excited, despite the fact that she is visibly still smarting from being punched. But Tourmaline's
still piggybacking.
The Pearl just tries to shake Tourmaline off.
She's holding on tight.
And she says, "We do not negotiate with terrorists."
Not terrorists.
What have we done to terrorize anyone?
Tourmaline, please, let her go. Just let me... They need to see this.
It's okay, Tourmaline. You can let go. If they act up, then I'll deal with them.
She hesitates a moment, then... In one fluid motion, she's gonna let go, drop down to the ground, and then run back to Trinitite.
Now, as he always goes, sort of stand there, both hands on his cane, it's standing there between his legs, going, "Right, now would you two be ever so kindly as just to follow me for a moment?"
Milpreve is following, and...
I'm taking them in the direction of the geode path.
And it's clear... Wait. In the geode path.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
When you guys see... as soon as the geode path comes into view, Milpreve has a bizarre look on her face, like half between disgusted and fascinated, but the pearl just goes, just blanches in horror, and she says, "You're sick, you know that? You're all sick!" And she grabs Milpreve's hand and tries to run away with her.
Before she tries, I'm going to grab her by the wrist. And go.
Roll either athletics or acrobatics.
I'm just standing there with my sledgehammer just behind them, just threateningly. Not threateningly, but you know, as kind of a, yeah, don't try it.
Moonstone's gonna give a hand with all four limbs, if that's okay.
Yep.
Alright, you roll two.
Can I assist in any way?
Are you going to be physically manhandling them?
I can try.
Alright.
I'll be giving myself a magic point, don't worry.
No, that's alright, because I have a thing for this as well, if I...
Oh, alright.
I guess... What is it? I should be rolling.
Athletics
or acrobatics?
Alright. 17, it's still better than yours, so...
15, 16, 17.
I have a thing that lets me swap my roll with your roll. So, you can have my 17.
That means... Means that you now have it.
I have a 15 and Azurite has a 17.
You?
I'm just sort of like,
all right,
there, just in between the two, just like, yeah, I wouldn't try it.
The pearl screams out, and she says, "Milpreve, now is the time to use that."
Milpreve. These geodes you see before you are all natural to this planet. They weren't crashed here. They all were made here.
You might, are they?
You don't know.
Oh, God.
Roll for bullshit.
Can I have studied them?
Can I roll history?
You can roll history to see what you know.
Yeah. I like to do that.
I kind of had it in my head that... Wait, are we all going?
I don't know.
Hmm.
Can we?
I mean,
I guess we could. I mean,
where else would we go? Is the question. Pyrite would follow because...
Okay, well, Pyrite, what you know is that... This is the place where there was a big gem battleground, and it was intended to be a kindergarten, but the battle was to break it. So, yes and no. These gems are a product of Earth's own power, but the reason they were able to grow the way they have is because of the gem seeds that never bloomed correctly because the kindergarten was broken.
Okay.
This is, in a way... sort of both a gem graveyard and a gem abortion.
Oh, God.
They don't.
Yeah.
They don't know that.
Azura is just bullshitting and trying to make a point.
Azura is just trying to bullshit.
Do you know what happened here?
Milpreve doesn't seem to be listening, actually.
By the way, just for clarity, I think Tourmaline will follow along with the others just to keep near everyone, and she'll take Trinitite with her if you'll be persuaded.
Well, Pyrite is speaking to both of them, so
Milbrief doesn't seem to be listening, but the Pearl is just snarling at you and muttering, sick, sick, sick!
Why?
Protecting a bunch of monkeys over actual people.
Moonstone kind of quietly grumbles, oh sure, like the stuff you guys have done to me or any indication.
Tourmaline just...
Actual people. And that's coming from a Pearl.
Alright.
Well, what is it with you today? You're being more mean than I am. And that's actually quite a challenge.
The homeworld.
Yes, they are. That doesn't mean you can be racist.
Pyrite, we're not.
Even I have limits.
You don't want to be treated like you're lesser because you're a metal. You shouldn't treat a Pearl any lesser because she's a Pearl.
That's the point.
Set by example.
Even I have limits.
You're talking about actual people. Like, actual people is something that can't. Unless Homeworld has changed anything in the last, I don't know how many years.
I get it, Pyrite. You were trying to make a point.
Sorry, I'm sifting through my notes a little bit.
Tourmaline is kind of looking over at the Pearl and saying, you know that you saying that humans aren't real people is like someone saying that you're not a real gem. It's just not true.
They're just overdeveloped. But before she can continue, the glass of Milpreve's headpiece actually goes red, and it shifts in size, and it shoots out 5 laser beams.
What?
As it does this, little football-sized crawly creatures appear, 5 of them, 1 for each laser, and start closing in on you.
No, what? What's she doing?
The Pearl grins and says, good girl, Milpreva, let's get out of here. And you'll all need to roll for initiative.
It's a good thing I have a bonus.
Well, we tried doing it peacefully, now I'm gonna smash some shit.
Alright, 14.
Is it just a straight d20?
Yeah, unless you,
you have any modifiers.
Get
a one.
Well, I guess it makes sense.
Does make a weird amount of sense.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
By the way, I haven't chosen all my equipment yet, but I have chosen Spellbook. So I am taking all weight of my combat talent.
I think everybody took Spellbook.
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah.
I haven't.
Who's got time for choosing? Well, okay, Logan has time for choosing 5.
Well, it does depend on what I'm going to be doing. It also is partly because when they're small, they don't really need to have 5.
Okay.
All right. So. Can I have a second to pick my new talents?
Alright, but I'll try and figure out what the order is.
Alright, I can take 5, right?
Yes. And what's everybody's initiative?
16.
Nat 1.
12.
I had, 14.
15.
Alright.
Minus 5.
Wait, yours is minus 5 or yours is 5?
Mine is 5.
Okay.
Alright.
Was Onyx the 15 or the 14?
Onyx is the 15.
Okay.
At least I tried.
We tried doing it in a nice way, now we're just gonna break shit.
I don't think we're gonna attack the homework drums.
I didn't say what specifically we were going to break, we're just going to break shit.
Mm-hmm.
Alright. Tourmaline, I believe you go first.
Oh my god, I got highest. That's just worrying.
Highest by one.
I'm actually gonna start off by dealing some damage. I'm gonna go ahead and do chain lightning. So deal 1d10 to target creature, and if I roll a 6 or higher, I can make the thing again. So let me roll a 1d10. No,
sorry, I'm looking at the turn order, I don't see where Azurite is.
Ah, okay. I'm flavoring this as, Tourmaline.
That's a crit!
Well then.
Hold off on me flavoring this, I just need to see what I can do next. Okay, for a 10, it's...
Oh dear.
For each enemy, flip a coin. If you win that flip, stun that enemy until the end of its next turn. May I roll a d2 and say a 2 is a pass and a 1 is a fail?
Mm-hmm.
You have 7 enemies I think you can stun, unless the drones all count as a horde.
Huh?
If it counts as a horde, then you stun them all.
Oh, Eli went dark.
Yeah, I think that's when he went quiet.
Yeah, I was just wondering if
you still passed.
While Eli's away, since I got over a 6, I can chain lightning again. I got a 4 this time, so I won't chain again. So I might as well just flavor it while we're waiting for Eli to come back. Which is Tourmaline leaps forward, resummons her bow staff, squarely hits one of the bugs on the head. For 10 damage plus stun, and then kind of whiplashes into one next to it.
It'd be funny if they only have 10 health to begin with, so that stun is just poof.
That would be fun.
Yeah, I was just wondering if these guys are probably not minion types, but it also depends on if it's a horde. I don't know if they move all at once. I just don't know if they're actually fight all at once. Like, what are they even saying? Like if it's a magneton over a magnetite horde, I guess is the best way to explain it.
Everyone use earthquake.
I actually have that ability.
Yeah. My biggest damage dealer is Frostfall.
My biggest damage dealer is Electrocution.
Yeah.
In direct damage,
technically,
my damage dealer is XD10.
Oh, nice. Yeah, Frostfall is pretty good, and then I have Lightning Bolt, which is like... I can deal 17 damage if I use it after. At max. Was that Eli
back? Last thing I heard was you critting.
Was what? Oh, critting.
Critting.
Okay, so what's happened while you were zarging is that Tourmaline has hit bug number 1, I'm assuming we're attacking the bugs.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Yep.
She has hit bug number 1 for 10 damage and stunned it. And that is stunned until the end of its next turn. And then she has also dealt 4 damage to bug 2.
Wait.
Alright.
What is your crit again?
My crit is dazzling thingy. Hang on. Dazzling performance. For each enemy, flip a coin. If you win that flip, stun that enemy until the end of its next turn. No?
But, hold on, does that say each enemy hit, okay, or just each enemy?
I'm assuming it's for each enemy that the crit hits.
Okay.
I don't know, but that would be what I'd guess. It's not terribly clear in the world.
Alright. Okay, so one has taken 10 damage and is stunned, and one took 4 damage, is that correct?
That is correct.
Alright, so next up on the initiative order will be,
me.
Yes, you.
I am gonna Arcane Bolt, which deals 1d6 to up to 3 creatures. How many bugs are there?
5.
There are 5 bugs.
Good, I hit 3 of them then.
Alright.
Yep. 1d6 to up to 3 creatures. So is that what, 1d6 for all of them, or...?
1d6 for all of them.
Yeah, so that's 5 for, I don't know, bug 1, 2, and 3.
So, alright. One explodes. However, with all the goo that falls on all the other bugs, they visibly get stronger and any damage they had is healed.
Oh god. This type of enemy.
Is speaking a free action?
Sorry, what?
Is talking a free action?
Yeah, talking's a free action.
Use diplomacy.
As soon as she sees this happening, Tourmaline's like, oh, hang on, let me just formulate what I'm saying so that Tourmaline isn't stumbling through it. Oh, that slime, it's healing. It has healing properties. We have to separate them.
Hang on, my Skype's derping. I'll be right back.
Mm-hmm.
All right, sorry about that. So, whose turn is next?
I think it's mine.
It is Moonstone.
Give me a sec. I want to look up something real quick. Oh, Dally, what crit does Tourmaline have?
Dazzling performance, I think.
Am I looking at an old thing, or don't you flip a coin for every enemy?
It says for each enemy, but I don't. But surely that would be for each enemy where I've rolled a 10? No?
I don't know, because that seems pretty underpowered for crit.
I would think each enemy does mean each enemy.
Yeah, I played this a while back, and every time it was, I think it was every enemy on the enemy side. But Eli has last words. I was just confused for a moment.
Oh, Okay. No, I don't doubt you. It's just the wording didn't make that clear.
Yeah.
That's fine. Yeah. That'd be incredibly helpful.
Yeah, I guess Eli maybe gets the final word on that.
Yeah.
Because he's armed.
You guys can go for it. No, so, I am.
Oh, you're not Zard. Okay. Yeah, so does that mean I can flip a coin for each of the other enemies then?
Yes.
Cool, okay, thank you. Wow, does that include Beach and Milkwreath?
Well, yes. You're fighting them. Are you fighting?
Would Tourmaline consider them enemies, I guess, is the way it was talked about when I played it.
Because they have initiated combat, so yes.
Okay, then.
Okay, so I'm going to roll...
The way I played it was... Oh, sorry.
I'm going to roll 6d2s.
Alright.
2s are successes, 1s are fails. Okay, it would help if I actually put that the right way around. I can type.
Watch it be 12 total. Watch it be 12 total.
Sorry?
I was just saying, watch it be 12 total and you stun them all. It looks like you only stunned 2 of the bugs, if we're going by initiative order.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
2 of the other bugs are stunned.
Yeah.
Bugs 4 and 5.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so...
Thanks for the clarification there, Logan.
Yeah, no problem. I just remember it because I played with Dan, and that's what I remember. I just thought I might have misremembered, though. Alright, for damage, I'm gonna go with Demand Duel on one of the bugs. Let's say bug 2 or something.
Alright.
One of the bugs that isn't stunned, if you have a list of it on the other side.
Alright. 1 is gone, so either 2 or 3.
Yeah, I'll go with 2.
Ooh,
4 damage.
Yes, I smushed 1.
Yeah, 4 damage, and if it attacks one of my allies on its turn, other than me, it takes another d8.
Mm-hmm.
Alright, and I have 5 pets.
Alright. That then makes it,
my turn.
Yep.
I'm going to be using Paranoia. Target enemy immediately makes an attack against a creature of my choice. Bug 3 is going to be... Right. Attacking bug 4.
Bug 5.
I'd say...
Alright.
The target chooses which attack to use. But...
The bug bites down on bug 4, which visibly shudders. But bug 3 is now looking healthier.
Oh good, they're vampires as well.
Oh no,
and
they have that move.
The way it's going to be flavored is Azor just points its cane, the head stick pointing towards the bugs, and it shines a dazzling blue color.
Before it attacks.
And, yep. I now have 5 pips. Your turn. No, 6 pips. Your turn.
Alright. So. Only 2 of the bugs can actually move. Bug 3 is actually going to run over and spit some slime at... Hang on, let me see here.
Come at me, bro.
At... Let's go with Azure. And this... Slime doesn't actually hurt you, but your feet are now cemented to the ground, and you'll have to roll a save end of some sort to try and get out when your next turn rolls around.
I'm fine with this.
And bug 2 is Bug 2 is going to go and bite Onyx on the ankles.
Motherfucker.
Freaking ankle biters.
But then
I love these stuffings.
The only kids here are freaking Speck and technically Trin, I'd say.
You get 6 damage.
Oh, he's getting smushed.
Step on. Very slowly, step on.
Oh, and now it is... oh, shit. I think... oh, I got this backwards. 12 was BG and Mill's turn. So, but the drones go right after, so no big deal. BG and Mill are running. The Pearl is basically just pulling Milpreve at high speed back towards the Nexus.
Didn't I have a hold of Pearl?
Mm-hmm.
So if she's running away and I'm still holding on, she's going to be pulling onto me, cemented onto the floor.
So she ain't going nowhere.
She could probably just try to tug herself out, then.
Wait, sorry, eyes aren't... What's happening?
Azurite has a hold of the Pearl, and the Azurite is stuck to the floor, so the Pearl ain't going anywhere.
Yeah, I think she could be taking the time to tug away.
Mm-hmm. Okay, one more time. Sorry.
Azurite is stuck to
is
the
floor. Is this about BG and Milpreve running?
Yes, Azurite is stuck to the floor. Azurite also has a hold of BG. So, if she's going
no,
to try...
No, you didn't. What?
No, not me.
I did. It happened at the big before.
Okay, you're gonna have to roll some athletics because she's yanking her arm out of your hand. Oh, and also, weren't you pointing at something with your cane?
Other hand. No. It's athletics. I'm not going to do well in this. Mm.
Well,
I'm really not going.
Magic point?
Oh!
You son of a bitch!
Damn.
Damn, son!
Okay.
Oh, is the above one opposing?
Milpreve hits you in the face with a laser. Roll endurance.
Does this do damage as well? I have to ask, because it is important. Okay, as a reaction for me taking damage, support me. Target ally may immediately use a full...
No, it doesn't do damage. It's just meant to make you let go.
It's just like pointing a laser pointer in your face.
Is heal pointing at that a thing?
In theory, yes.
It's up to you, man.
I mean, yeah. I don't want them to escape.
Wait, didn't you already... Wait, no, that was Hatter there.
Sorry. They're not necessarily going to escape. Even if Azure doesn't manage to keep a grip on them, we can chase after them.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I didn't get to use my magic point because I was told not to use it because someone else had something better, yeah.
Instead of 10, I got a 20.
Alright, so you add plus 10, yes?
Yep. Unless someone else has something against it, yes.
Yep.
Alright. So, Azur, you managed to hold on to BG. But You are blinded, Savens, along with your being cemented to the floor, Savens.
Who says I need to see?
That means you'll have to roll 1d2 for every attack you try to make. On a 1, you miss.
I'm fine with this. I don't need to do damage.
It is now Pyrite's turn.
Pyrite will sit there and fume a bit. But really, she's doing Dark Bargain. Suffering 2 ongoing damage to save ends. From
all right.
Ability,
what
2
does that
save
do?
Ends.
Remind me.
And a -2 penalty to damage save ends. Also, she cannot make saving
all
turns.
Right.
Throws this turn. And she gains... energy from that.
All right. All right. That makes it Spectrolite's turn. And Spectrolite is going to use shiny things or trance. So Spectrolite gains 4 pips and suffers vulnerability 4 until the end of his next turn. Now it is Trinitite's turn.
Trine is just going to be standing in the middle of the path of where they came up. So when BG books it that way, he's gonna get like run over. But he's just gonna like try and contain the amount of just energy that is attempting to escape at the moment, because he's still shaking like a leaf. Which is control the power. I gain resist 3, and if I don't take any damage until my next turn, I gain 2 more energy.
All right.
That's it.
And circling back around to the top, the initiative.
Hello. I'm gonna do a simple stab. Well, actually, would it be a standard or minor action to punt one of the bugs away from its fellow bugs? With my bow staff. You there, dude?
Would you be able to what?
Would it be
a
standard
so.
Or minor action to use my bow staff to punt away one of the bugs? So that it's not nearby the
I'll
other bugs.
I'll call that... Depends on how far you want to... Depends how far you want to punt it. Because if you're getting it to the opposite side of the battle, it'll be minor. If you're getting it to, out of the battle, it'll be standard.
Opposite side of the battle. I just want to get it far enough away that it's not going to heal its fellows or be healed by its fellows. Is that okay? Dark.
All right. Yes, but I heard most of it. Okay. So
yeah.
That's a minor action, so you still have your standard.
Okay, so as a minor, I'm terribly sorry. How many is it, bugs 2 through 5 left?
Yes.
Punting bug number 2. And then hitting bug number 3. So yeah. Do you want me to roll athletics or anything to punt a bug?
Punt a bug.
Or Do we just take...
Nah.
Okay. So, yeah, she...
That seems like something you could do pretty automatically.
Fair. So she swipes her bow staff at Bug 2 and punts it away from the others, and then she brings her staff down hard on Bug 3, and that is going to be stab, deal 1d10 damage. So...
Okay.
And that's 5 damage to Bug 3.
Bug 3 cracks a bit, but is not dead.
Thank you. And that's me.
Okay. Onyx is next.
Yeah. Well, I'm gonna just weld to an arcing bolt again, and the one that bit me, obviously, that little shit's gonna die. And
that would be number two.
Yeah, two.
I just punted three, it away from you.
Oh, 3, 4, and 5 then, and she's just smacking them like golf balls. Keeping them away from each other.
All right.
And that is 1, 5 to 3, 4, and 5. She just smacks it away, goes to another one, smacks it. Like golf, but with bugs and a sledgehammer.
Alright, number 3 explodes, and since you golfed it, it'll actually spurt fluid all over you guys, and you're now all not stuck the way that that the good, you're not stuck, but you'll be getting a penalty on any athletic or acrobatics rolls.
Mm-hmm.
Save ends.
Because you're covered in sticky film. Yeah, save ends. Now, next up is... Moonstone. Logan?
Okay. Sorry, I zoned out for a little bit.
It's alright.
Let's see.
There's only 3 bugs left.
I'm going to be crit fishing. That's definitely no crit fishing.
Alright.
Yeah, so after smacking at the things, Moonstone kind of just glares at the other 3, calculating.
Mm-hmm.
And next turn.
Next up is Azure.
Azure is going to be taking a...
You are both...
Calm
you're
breath.
You're both blind, save ends, and... Alright.
And basically, he, as a standard utility, he's using Gather Energy.
Okay.
Do I only do the 1 save ends, or...?
You roll 2d20, 1 for each.
2d20, do you say?
Yeah. A d20 for each save ends condition.
Jesus!
Not only do you not save against any of them, you actually feel a little more stuck now.
Good job.
And oh, now it is BG and Milpreve's turn. So,
I
That is BG's roll to escape your grip. Roll opposing athletics or athletics with a minus five.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, no, Azul will just let go.
Alright, then BG is hauling ass with Milpreve in tow. And when she nears Trinitite, she is going to... basically just throw Milpreve over you and yell, "Keep going!" before trying to stab you with her claws.
Oh,
motherfucker. Okay, hold up now.
You're going the
I
fuck
don't...
down.
Wait, what?
Well, hold on. Here's the issue. I can basically negate everything that's going to happen, like, super well. The issue is, in character, I don't think he's thinking about any of this.
Do whatever feels best, Hacker.
Is this a single attack?
Either way, you take three damage.
Is this a single target? Single
yes.
Target attack. Okay, I automatically have resist two against it. And I
yes.
also have resist three from control power. All
right.
So he hits me and does jack shit. So it just like clinks off of Trine's natural, like, amazing armor.
Natural awesomeness.
Yeah,
like
but
the glass casing.
Milpreve has been thrown over you and is still running.
I don't.
And
really
that
think.
Makes it. That makes it the bug's turn. So, they are all going to crawl into the middle of all of you, and simultaneously explode.
Okay.
Everyone is now covered in sticky foam. That makes it very difficult to move.
Joy.
Except for Trinitite and BG, since they were apart from the group.
So, what condition is this?
It is basically minus 15 to all athletics or acrobatics rolls save ends.
Okay.
Eek.
Fuck everything.
Hmm.
Yeah, I'm free. I'm still blind.
So, basically, combat is over for now.
Wait, what?
What do you want to do?
Wait, what?
What?
We...
The only person...
I was gonna wait till my next turn and just be using Crit Fisher to try to give us all saving throws. If need be.
Why are we ending combat?
Because there's no one else around to fight.
BG.
BG's...
The only person still fighting is BG, and she's mainly just trying to stab it at Trinitite and be between you guys and Milpreve, who is running.
Yeah, and I still would like to be in combat just because I can heal us from the goop.
Alright, that is your prerogative then. That means that next up is Pyrite's turn.
Okay.
Wait, what?
You said you're still in combat, so we're still going down the turn order.
Alright. Sorry.
So,
sorry.
Apparently none of them are within range.
You could theoretically get into range of BG, but not of Milpreve.
Nah. I mean, I could do 40-10 damage, but I don't really wanna. Pyrite's just gonna walk over.
Alright.
And
roll...
Yeah, save four times.
Wait, then what?
She's gonna save on her conditions four times.
Is that an ability? Or?
Now you just gotta save once. Oh.
Yeah, I have four conditions.
Well, either way, you have absolutely saved, so you managed to shake off all the slime.
Shaked off everything.
And Pyrite's just gonna walk over and say, hey, I don't actually want to fight you. And I don't actually want to do anything bad to you. I just don't want this place to be hurt. And I hope you can help me with this. But if you can't, then we'll find another solution.
That's usually me.
Sorry, I'm zarging.
My eyes, they burn.
But I think...
Walk it off.
But, with that, BG is still just between you guys and the direction in which Milbreeve went, and she said, all right.
All right, Zog.
Okay. Finally back. You said, I don't want to fight, correct?
Essentially, yep. Yes.
BG then looks over her shoulder, slowly stands up, her weapon dissipates, and she says, I don't want to fight anymore either. I've done my job.
We don't want this place to get hurt, or the people. They are people. The people who live here, we don't want them to be hurt either. And if you can help us with that...
We didn't come here to hurt that.
Well, you apparently know that they are going to be hurt. And I'm not going to say you didn't, but if you can help us with preventing them from getting hurt, we would really like that. If you can't, then I think we might find another solution.
I'll see what orders I get. And she vanishes into her gem, which just clatters to the ground.
What?
What?
Pyrite walks over and picks her up. Can I do that? Eli?
Okay, what happened? Yes?
She disappeared into her gem, and Pyrite just walks over, picks her up, and is like, what? What?
What the fuck just happened?
What? Oh, Moral, that's changed so much. A pearl is allowed to not just stand there, and they just disappear into their gems without any reason. And she walks over to the pad.
You've gone a good deal away from the pad, you know?
What's the status on Milkreath? And
you went away.
And can the rest
yeah,
of us...
But,
you
but,
went
but,
away from the path.
Pyrite walks back towards the path.
But you're just going to leave us then.
However, can I just say that right. There was quite a long conversation that Pyrite had with BG. Would it be okay if we learned A, what Milkreath did in that time, and B, what the rest of us were doing, because some of us might have wanted to catch Milkreath?
Yeah.
Would that be okay?
All right. And yes, during the conversation, the foam did dissipate.
Good. Running out.
Do I have my eyesight back yet?
I'd use my super special ability, my super speed ability, if I could, but Trine's a little distracted, and I use it as a sight gag last session.
Fair.
Legging it.
Is Milkweep anywhere to be seen?
Nope. You can roll perception to try and find her.
Yes.
Oh. That. I'll give you a hand with that.
Oh, perception. It's not like that's the best skill Tourmaline has.
Do we still have that bonus from Grandeur?
Only if you can see Moonstone. So since Moonstone's on their way, those at the pad won't be able to get it until they are at the pad.
Actually, you know what? It'll be taking some time. Can I do a bit of flavors? Like, it was taking some time to get unstuck, and during this time, Azur casts Arcane Eye.
Alright, sure.
Sweet. Let me just check what all my stats are now. Okay.
Tourmaline, incidentally, as soon as she gets free, is running back towards the teleport pad while looking for Milkreath.
Yep.
Presumably so is Onyx.
I'll spell out her name.
Yeah, also, thanks. Eli, I can't...
Oh, Milkreath, right.
57.
You just called
I rolled
milk.
In at 2.
Mm-hmm. Because you rolled a nat 2, your eye is still having trouble seeing.
Yeah, I'm not using my actual eyes. I create an invisible eye.
I know, but you still... You're still having trouble seeing because you rolled a nat 2, DM says.
The dice god saith.
Just go with it.
I'm going to.
But, however, you are able to see that you're able to see just the last bits of her jumping into the fixed teleporter and beaming away.
No, no!
Fuck. Tourmaline
tries to speed up.
She's in a teleporter.
Damn it, she's not within. Like, we're too far away. I can't just flash teleport and tackle her out.
I'll give you guys a chance to roll something to try and stop her, but you have the disadvantage of having to wait or try to wrestle out of the murk.
How far exactly is she away? Like, in meters?
Further than whatever you're thinking of.
Would she be...
Remember, you took them to look at the geode path.
Would I potentially be able to try something? Arcana, but with a certain flavor.
Alright, what would you like to try?
What I would like to try... is to use an Arcana check, flavoring it as thus. Tourmaline would stick her hands directly into the red goo and draw the colour out of it, and in doing so try to draw the power out of it at the same time.
You'll need to roll Arcana for that, but I like it.
Yeah, like that I said, that's the flavoring, but it would be Arcana. Thank you. What is my Arcana? Mm-hmm. 7.
I don't even know what's going on.
Oh.
What?
Well, you said 7?
No. I haven't rolled a 7. That's my bonus. That's a 20, and I'd actually like to magic point that for 30.
All right. then you are able to, by sucking the red out of it, it just sort of turns into ineffectual foam. But what do you mean you have no idea what's going on, Ellen?
Well, the pearl just pops back into her gem, and Pyrite's just standing with her gem in her hands.
Pyrite is confused because Pyrite can't give up on old world beliefs.
No. That was a joke when I said that, yeah, but...
But with that, sorry, go on.
Right, it's fine.
With that, you guys do have some extra time now to try and catch her.
Flying.
Flash teleport and just sprinting.
Flash teleport one more time.
Yeah, that was my last one of the day. So I just use it just to get out of the goo and as far as I can. So just the full 30 feet and then just leg it.
Alright. If you're running, roll athletics or acrobatics. And if you're flying, roll acrobatics.
A double double. Here's where I'm going to learn that I should have saved my magic point.
Yeah.
Spectrolite is running alongside Onyx and just yelling, "Wait, we're not going to hurt you. We just want to know what's up." And all right. Oh, son of a bitch.
Oh,
that's about one, actually.
Ooh.
Anyone got anywhere?
Does anyone
want to
do something with that?
What exactly was Beck doing? Was he flying?
No, it was a mechanics roll. What can we do?
Hang on, what was spec rolling for? Was it spec?
Was it spec or milk?
It was not. You guys actually hear a crash up ahead.
Was it amber?
Might have been milk.
One of the three.
Then there is a bright beam of light and a bunch of trees and branches start falling in your path.
Oh, okay. You're doing that.
Shit.
Okay, Spec can fly. Going to
I'm just gonna
Yes, Marty.
I was gonna say you go over it. It's just had a sort of a, not really a thing that happened. It just reminded me of a thing. It's like, just you go over it, Spec can go under it, and Onyx will just go through it.
Over the river, through the woods, see whatever the fuck is going on.
Like over and
when you go over it, you can see Milpreve is on the ground, and she has her hand on her helmet, and has turned the eyepiece to its largest setting, and it's glowing bright red. Stay back!
Please.
I know how to use this!
Please, 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 please. And she's kind of got her hands up. She's not holding her bow staff anymore. And would it be totally cheesy of me to activate kindness? I mean, compassion.
Do it.
Yeah.
I'm going to do it, but I'm going to say that Eli can, you know, disprove it if he wants to, because we've already done once this session. I mean, obviously he can, he's the DM.
You do activate kindness, and you understand that she's hostile because she's terrified and she's just trying to get back at home so she can get back to her boss and get help for BG.
Please.
But when you activate kindness, she's no longer hostile, but that means fear takes over, so she's running again.
Please wait, she chases. Please, if you go back...
Okay! So, this time, she's gone.
Eli, hang on. Is Onyx within 50 feet of the portal?
Yes.
All right, good. And it uses light, doesn't it?
It does.
Good. I use light trap. I pull all of the light within 50 feet around me into an object I'm holding. So I basically grab the light from the portal and just pull it into my hammer. So, yeah, the portal
does... You hear a crackling noise, and all gems in the vicinity roll endurance.
Oh, wait, shit. Yeah, we're made of light, aren't we?
Oops.
Including Onyx.
I didn't think this through properly.
Oh, wow, that didn't occur to me.
No, that didn't occur to me either.
Wait, what?
All gems within the vicinity of Onyx's move have to roll endurance, including Onyx.
Everyone within 50 feet of
Onyx. Well, it was nice knowing you, everyone.
And yeah!
TPK!
And you hear Spectrolite scream.
I'm not there.
I suppose...
Oh, shit.
As soon as that happens, as soon as like she hears Spectre scream, she just instantly stops.
Wait, what just happened?
I didn't realize that we are also made of light and uses an ability that absorbs light.
What does Tourmaline snap to?
Okay, none of you are hurt, but Speck is curled up on the ground and trembling and crying. And Milpreve is just crawling it towards the gem tech light.
But yeah, as soon as she hears Spec, she just instantly stops, and all the light comes back. It's just like shit, and just runs over to Spec.
Can Pyrite run over to Spec too?
Yes, you can.
So hang on, we're just
the pearl.
What? Can I
because
just
why?
What do you want to do, Dally?
Sorry, I'm just wanting to check. The fact that Spectrolite and Milpreve seem to be hurt by that, was that to do with their low rolls, or was that just an extra character?
No, everyone was hurt by that. Spec was just the one who happened to scream.
Okay, but...
Because it wouldn't have actually hurt your gems, because those aren't made of light. But using that would have caused... If you'd failed the endurance roll, and if Onyx hadn't stopped, would have caused you to insta-poof.
Okay. But it was a low DC.
And she pretty much instantly stopped as soon as Spec was like, oh shit, I'm hurting Spec.
Spec just clings to Onyx and is shaking and crying.
Oh my god, like, oh, because she's light, of course.
I'm sorry, Spec. I forgot you were there. Oh, God, I'm so sorry.
And is there anything else anyone wants to do?
I had a thing.
Yeah.
What's-her-face is still here, isn't she?
She is on she's at the Nexus. She's not gone. But aren't you and Pyrite back at the... back near towards the geode pass?
Well, everyone ran off, but Trine is still, like, shaking, so he's just slowly walking back towards the Nexus, but, like...
I mean, Pyrite would be walking alongside Trinitite until Spec called out, screamed, then she would be running towards Spec.
Azurite would probably catch up with Trin after a while. After getting all the gunk out of his eyes and actually getting out that damned hole.
I mean, like, everyone ran off he'd slowly start walking that way? How close would he be at this point?
You're close enough to see what just happened, though you weren't a part of it, so you're at least 50 feet behind Onyx.
So...
all you saw was just an area just suddenly go black, and then but, stop.
What's-her-face is still... she's still here, and
yes,
she's
she
on
is.
The teleport pad.
Yeah, she is curled up in a fetal position on the teleport pad, but her fingers are moving against it, and it's starting to glow.
Never mind, he won't get there in time.
And I don't have any more uses.
Pyrite was doing something?
Pyrite was running towards Spectrolite, still with the pearl in her hands. Why would she do that?
Yep, you got the pearl.
Okay.
And, you guys see the teleport pad light up.
Tourmaline is going
to... and Milbreeve is gone.
Fly straight ship.
Can Tourmaline reach it?
Tourmaline did not stop flying.
Yeah.
Wait, you didn't?
No.
But that was what I was giving you all an opportunity to say.
Well, I was trying to, but I wanted to make sure everyone else got to say something.
Yeah.
All right, my bad.
I
All right, so you get a chance to do one thing. What are you going to do?
Fly directly, or if she can. She's trying to fly directly into the teleport crystal, teleport pad, and grab Milbreeve.
Roll acrobatics.
Oh. 28.
You do it, and it lights up, but it lights up without you or Milbreeve in it. And Milbreeve just lies on the ground, tackled by you, and starts crying.
Please, I'm really sorry. I don't want to have to hurt you. I'm not going to hurt you. I'm sorry. But... they said... She said they were going to blow up Earth.
And Milbreeve looks up and says,
"No, but... We're gonna have to destroy this place because the experiments failed. Because it might be dangerous. The Glasswoods.
We can help. We can stop them from being dangerous. You wanted to check on the experiments, right? We can still do that.
Yeah.
I'm sorry.
But BG's gone.
I don't understand. Will she come back? We're not gonna hurt her gem. She'll be fine.
Curls up and just says,
"I'm Milbreeve. My serial number is 27483. I am a scout, and I am not obliged to tell you anything else."
Tourmaline just kind of gets off her, still on the teleport pad, and kind of curls up in a bowl herself. Everyone got hurt. Everyone's all hurt, and Amber's still out there, and I don't know what's going on. I don't. And I left Trin, and I left Spec, because I didn't want...
Oh. And if anyone tries to talk to her again, that's all she'll say. She'll just repeat that again and again.
Tourmaline, yeah, just stays in fetal position.
And, unless there's anything else anyone wants to do, that could be the session.
Trin walks up to Tourmaline and then just curls around her.
I think I broke her.
For the record, oh, Pyrite, you would notice this. Her helmet sent something. It's a video recording of everything that just happened from her perspective.
And it sent it into space, didn't it?
Yep.
Oh, fuck. We can't intercept a signal that moves at the speed of light. Well, unless you have FTL travel, which they have. So, it moves faster than that. Yep. Fucked.
Is that all? Is any of that in character, or is that just out of character?
Pyrite is like, oh shit. And then the session ends.
Spectrolite actually it has a bit of a limp, but
Onyx is just trying to support him.
Sorry, typing something.
Still apologizing.
And Spec says, "It's okay, Onyx. It happens. I make mistakes all the time." And Spectrolite tries to talk to Milpreve, but just gets the same response.
The only way this could get any worse is if there was still a manticore in my house.
Oh, wait.
We'll get to the manticore.
I need a cup of tea. To be fair, whatever was sent, if anything was, we weren't the first ones to make hostile actions.
They did indeed start it first.
Well, we stopped them from leaving again, but that's after they suggested that we did something, that they would do something bad. But yeah, when Pyrite gets up to Spec and Onyx, she's gonna first make sure Spec's okay, and then sit to Onyx, "You don't do that again. I know you fucked up, and Gems fuck up. Just don't do that again."
He just stares up at him. I can't remember everyone's. I think she's a girl, isn't she?
She is.
Yeah. He just stares up at her like, "Yeah, I don't need it from you right now. I feel bad enough as it is."
Spec says, "It's okay. It's okay. I'm going to be fine. It's still a good plan."
Tourmaline has taken off her visor and is crying quite a lot at this point, rocking back and forward, and she murmurs, "You said they sent something?"
"Yeah, they sent a message. It's everything that happened since she came here."
"Well, then they already know. We should just let them go home. It's not gonna help. I'm not going to help anymore, if they already know."
And Trin's just continuing to be next to him. Stuff.
Yep. Well, is Trin caught up with him now?
Yeah, when she called up, Trin walked over and called up with her.
She's kind of got a hand on Trin, and looks like she wants to apologize to him, but she's just having too hard a time functioning right now.
Spectrolite crouches down in front of Milpreet and says, "I was scared too. We can be your friends." And she repeats her name and serial number.
I told you, Spec, I broke her. She should just go home.
If she was broken, she'd be cracked.
No, Spec, not like that. Like the way humans get broken inside sometimes.
Spec, I think we should all just go home and have some rest. Maybe you can tell me some stories.
Give me one moment. I like stories.
Well, when we get back, if I'm allowed, I'll trade some stories with you if you trade some stories with me.
I don't have very many, but I can make them up real good. I had a lot of time to practice making up stories.
I'd like to listen.
Spectrolite smiles. Sorry, I've got a thing I'm prepping.
Were we not ending the session?
Well, he said we could.
Yes, but there is one last thing. There is one last thing I want to do.
Okay.
Let's just complete a moment.
That's fair.
Tourmaline's just kind of scrubbing at her eyes and going, "Can we let them go home?"
We can.
Milgrave actually looks up and says, "If I can go home, can I have BG back?"
She knows Vigorous.
Oh, yeah.
Moonstone kind of just nods his head, too. Their head.
Pyrite gives
Mel
BG?
The pearl is BG, and Milpreet's the one who's still ungemmed.
Yeah. Pyrite gives BG.
As you give the gem to her, her thing actually lights up again. Once again, it's red, but this time it forms a hologram of a red silhouette, and which says, as in a distorted voice, "Two rogue gems. We appear to be at an unintentional cross-purpose. Our mission involving the Glasswood specimen needs to succeed, and we're willing to negotiate. We have no desire to liquidate the area."
Wait, what?
I need a cup of tea.
Do they mean that?
Milpreet blinks and says, "I think so. Boss doesn't like liquidating things. Beach is still being all pouty, so she probably won't be out for a while, but she knows more about Boss than I do."
Maybe you go home and you say, "We don't mean any harm."
He knows that. I mean, I think he knows that. He saw everything I saw.
Milpreet, I'm really sorry I broke you. I'm not good at it. She just kind of trails off.
She actually takes off her helmet, revealing that she has... hang on, let me find the link.
Some of us just aren't good with social.
Moonstone quietly mumbles mostly about themselves, most of us.
Fine, hold four more.
But, she takes off her helmet, revealing that the other half of her head is, in fact, shaved bald, and around the eye that was covered the whole time is this.
Oh.
And Spectrolite actually crawls over and says, "Cool." And he grabs her face in much the same way she grabbed his arms.
Spec, don't be grabbing.
Oh, that is.
But she did it before.
He has a point.
And she actually swats him away a little, and she says, "Eh."
See, that
feels weird.
Yeah, that's why you don't grab me.
Spec, look, but don't touch.
Okay.
But, yeah, that's, I'm not broken, see? I know there's a hole, but that's always there.
Yeah, it's meant to be there. It does look pretty cool, I have to agree with Spec on that.
Make you sad.
That's my gem.
And she says, "I was more scared than sad, but if you guys wanted to hurt me, you could have done it already, I think. Because Beach is all gemmed, and she's the one who fights, not me."
Why is she all gemmed? That?
Because she's throwing a tantrum.
Go back in your
gem,
just like that?
She can. I don't know how. And her helmet lights back up and beams in the red hologram into the air. "However, this proposal is only valid while our subordinates are well. Should they remain unharmed, we will negotiate terms when our pearl is active again." "That means Beach," Milpreve says. "She'll be out in a few, She briefly puts her helmet over her face again and then takes it off. Days. That's the word. Days.
Why?
She'll be out in a few of those.
Why do you call her Beach?
Because she's a bright gold pearl, and I can't just call her Pearl because there's a whole bunch of pearls."
She just blinks. "There was a whole bunch of Tourmaline when I was a soldier, and they always just called me Tourmaline."
"Well, that's confusing."
"Yeah, it is."
"Yeah. But
Moonstone
always,
kind of.
They always wanted us to do the same thing, so it didn't really matter."
Moonstone
kind
of
confusing and stupid.
"Well, here I'm the only Tourmaline, so it's okay."
"And what's Moonstone doing?"
Moonstone just kind of scratches her head. "Yeah, it was always a pain with me, too. Plus, that being Gen Nalatide means that doesn't happen as often, but.
How come you fused?"
Moonstone just kind of stares, eyes going a little cold.
It's a different thing.
Let's just say I'm a failed experiment too and be done with it. I don't want to relive that."
"Oh, right! Since you guys aren't going to kill me, I need to do my job." Milpreve puts her helmet back on and says, "And the thing is, She makes a hologram of an arrow pointing towards the Golden Woods that way, and
if it's our house, I swear.
Is there a way to get there without the going through the gem miscarriage?"
"You can go over it,
all around.
Okay, cool. That's cool." And she says, "You know, since I'm kind of your hostage and all, we should maybe stick together and stuff, and maybe you guys can make sure that I don't run off while also I get information?
Normally, terms and agreements are made on our end.
Onyx just slightly smiles and just looks to Spec and just points at Milk and goes, friend.
Spec tackle hugs Milpreet. Friend! And just picks her up, and Milpreet's just like, what the hell? What the hell? Is this an attack? Am I being killed?
No, this is just Spec. This is just how he says hello.
Now he'll never leave you
Spec
alone.
Drops her and
you're
then
one
grabs
of
her
us.
And then shakes it and says, I'm Spectrolite.
Right.
And apparently I'm 6,000 years old. It's really nice to meet you.
Well, probably
and
more
if
than
if no
6,
one else
10.
Has anything to do, that's where I'll call the session.
Yay. I like that ending a bit better.
I like
Yay.
That ending.
Yes.
Yeah, like it do.
Did you guys have fun?
Yeah.
I did.
Yep.
Thank you, Eli, and thank you for being patient with me and my slight bullshit there.
Of course. Thank you all very much for playing with me, and thank you, Dally, for streaming. I really hope you guys enjoyed.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
I had fun. Trin got to be adorable and then freaked the fuck out.
I honestly didn't think that. I was like, so that thing's made of light. I have an ability that takes the light.
I would not have done that if that wasn't your reasoning. I'm saying that you can do that without taking away gem light, but you explicitly said, I'm going to take the gem light.
No, I was just taking the lift light.
Which is gem tech, which is made of gems.
I didn't know that. Well, Onyx didn't know that, and I didn't know that either.
One question. May I make a pun?
Yes.
This was a very enlightening experience, then.
Mm.
All things considered, I didn't think about that either, Smarty. But now that I know this, I think some of these living needs to be taken care of.
Yeah,
no, as far as I'm concerned, you can decide whether you're taking regular light or regular light
I
and gem light.
She was just kind of in a rush, and it didn't occur to her. And she was just like, no, fuck it, grab the light.
Mm-hmm. No, it's fine. It's
that wasn't too much bullshit on my part, was it?
No,
that was fine.
Can I just apologize for taking everyone to the pretty much abortion clinic of gems?
I feel like Foresight's 2020, but I didn't think they'd react that way. But
yeah,
if,
I didn't either.
If you had seen it coming, I think you should have stopped like around the corner and said, "What you're going to see may shock and disturb you." But let me explain.
This isn't Ripley's.
The following images may not be suited for small gems.
Yeah, believe it or not, this isn't a cartoon.
I hate you.
Christ. I heard that laugh.
Also, I did
still
not...
hate you.
It sounds like a papyrus.
I did not expect more than one kind of pearl.
I can kind of get that, mostly because gemstones do come in different colors, and I think if you just look up pearl, you can probably find a couple of them.
A lot of different colors of pearls.
Yeah. It's like how quartz has a lot of colors, how like moonstone does, and heck, you know what Obi's character was going to be beryl? That's actually part emerald. Emerald is a beryllium thing, so it does depend.
I am going to tell you guys, that's not the last pearl you'll meet.
I'm glad. I like pearls.
Rather pretty.
Mm-hmm. Destroy us all. Destroy us all.
Okay.
BD is funny, though. I like her.
Also, I did not expect homeworld intervention.
I really hope it, you guys. And I really enjoyed DMing that.
Good.
I loved this. I loved this little mini session, even though it turned into more of a nasty session.
I did not expect homeworld interaction in the second session.
Yeah, I thought it was.
Honestly, hell no.
Me neither, but it was awesome.
It was.
Did you guys like Milprieve and BG?
I did like Milprieve. Milprieve is like another spec. That's adorable.
That was deliberate.
Pyrite has some issues.
I was totally prepared to start singing I Will Show You the World.
Same. I even said it in the stupid thing after, I think it was Smarty you mentioned it. Also, Trin is a traumatized little one, and I want to hug him and squeeze him, but that might not help.
Yes.
Oh, no, the one person that he trusts, even slightly trusts, did not help. So, yeah, no.
No. And Moonstone probably doesn't help that much either, just because...
Oh, he's still shaking.
Okay,
yeah.
You guys, I'm
going to
go ahead and stop the stream.
All right.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Wait, we were streaming?
You're still streaming, yeah.
Yes.
I didn't even realize we were streaming at all. Sorry.
Okay, well, anyway, now we're going to not. So goodbye, streamies, and thank you, everyone.
Bye, streamies. Bye.